बोले सोने हाल सास भी अकाल।
Meet Kaur.
My name is Gurnam Singh.
Welcome to the one show.
Vaheguru Ji Khalsa.
Vaheguru Ji Fateh.
This is a one show special, one show extra. In today's one show, I've got independent documentary maker Tina Kaur, who's made a groundbreaking documentary called When the Sun Didn't Rise, The Sikh Massacre in October, November 1984. And she's arrived in the UK just very recently to show the documentary, and there's a whole list of screenings. And just this evening, there was a screening at the Gurnan Gurdas Smedic. So Tina, welcome to the show and welcome to the UK. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa. So just to say something about your background, as I said, this documentary has actually been received as the best docu-feature by an emerging filmmaker in the Asia Pacific Film Festival last year. So that's a wonderful achievement. And it premiered in Kerala, at the India Kerala IDSFFK. In June. So what has been the reception in some of these premieres?
So, you know, in Kerala, I was there for the screening of the documentary, and it was very heartening because people, they just read the English subtitles, because the entire film was in Punjabi and Hindi, you know, and they were very, very warm about it, and they really, you know, they liked it a lot, and they were very emotional by the end of the film, and the women hugged me, and they said that, you know, you take the film further ahead and you show it, because you know, we didn't know that this is what
that it was so powerful that they said that.
Yes, take it ahead. And when I was walking on the streets, you know, men came to me and said, "Are you the one who made this film?"
That's amazing. Yeah. Oh, wow. And just to dash kind of dasma, we Satina's on tour across the country at universities and gurdwaras, and so far on Wednesday there was a showing at the University College London. And yesterday at the London School of Economics, and I said today, this evening, it was at Guru Nanak Gurdwara in Smedic. What's been the initial response that you've had to your documentary?
See, in universities, the students, the Sikh students, and you know what the thing is, that they're little, it's not their fault also, because you know, so many things happened in 84, and you know, there was this Operation Blue Star in June, and this happened. So you know, the people have this, and this massacre is not really written about. Kithe history te da zikr nahi hega. I don't think it's their fault also ki they watched the film and they got to know what the truth is. That's why then.
Yeah, but it's a shame that the parents couldn't. Yeah. Talk about 1984.
Is it because it's too painful? Is that part?
Of course, it's very painful, and also in the minds of people, you know, the perception is very mixed. Yeah. Some people said that is it really that bad? Did we kill someone?
Oh, right.
You know, so they also asked me such question. Ki sikha ne bhi maria siga ki? Then I told them no. Nothing of that sort happened. There are no reports.
Like blaming yourselves.
Yeah, they said ki koi AOG FIR, koi proof nahi hai ga. Between 31st October, 3rd of November, je sikha ne kisi nu mara, AOG koi gal kithe nahi hoi. Chahe Punjab hoi, chahe pura desh hoi, hai na?
Jagdish Singh, is a human rights activist, and you know, there's a kind of tragedy here. This is not ancient history. This is our recent history, and doubts are being put in there, and also the youngsters don't even know about. Isn't this another genocide in the sense, the genocide of the mind?
It's a double, triple genocide, both within the Indian system. There's been leading Indian politicians, and if I'm not mistaken, Manmohan Singh himself, the PM, said at one point that I'm an Indian first and a Sikh afterwards. And furthermore, Sikhs should now forget about 84, right? It's like saying to a Jew, forget about the Holocaust, right?
Yeah.
Now, the pain borne by the Sikh global population, the horror stories of 1984, both June and November, which are still unraveling even now.
Yes, of course.
We'll never have the complete picture.
No.
And all of this great documentary and research.
So this is absolute, I mean, you know, this is a groundbreaking work, and it's absolutely essential. You know, again, you know, if you lose your history, it's like a tree without roots. Malcolm X said that.
No, Marcus Garvey.
He said that. It's like a tree without roots. You'll fall over.
If you don't have no knowledge of your history, you're like a tree without roots.
You're clueless,
But the tragedy is, the double, triple tragedy, not only is the Indian system doing this to us, But the international system, the so-called international community, has refused to engage with the question of 1984.
Okay. Right, Tina, what inspired you to make this documentary?
See, you know, I had done my first documentary on Hola Mahalla, and I was researching on the subject of 1984. And it was my Mamaji who traveled in Madhya Pradesh, Patni, and his hair were pulled out. He was pulled out of the train and his hair were cut.
Right.
So he was.
So that was your mama ji.
Mama ji, hanji.
अच्छा मामियाँ देना तो उतना वैसे प्यार बहुत होता है यार.
बहुत हाँ.
So his hair was cut.
His hair
How
was cut.
How old were you then at the time?
Yeah. I was very small. I didn't remember
so
all of that.
So you don't remember.
But the thing is that when I was growing up, because I've always been an outsider.
But when you found out, how did you feel?
I really felt very bad about it. I really wanted to know what happened exactly. Why is my mother so angry on all these people, you know? So I wanted to know what the truth was. The other connect was also the fact that I was in Bombay and I was, you know, struggling to make a mark. And I said, if am I being educated, my journey can be so difficult. What happened to the women in 1984?
Yeah.
You know, 29 years later, where are they? You know, what is their journey like? Ona de bacche kida ne? Main janna chahni hai. Ona ne kida khade hoke sab cheeza da samna kita.
So why did it take you so long to make this documentary? It took you 5 years.
Yes.
Why was that?
See, there are many things behind it. First thing is, you know, a documentary film has to be well researched. You know, so mostly, you know, it's like, it's not a journalistic piece. It's not like you go to place and ask, ki tanu kidda lagda pe, you know, and just put the interviews together.
So you have to do your background research and
You have to do a lot of background research and try and encapsulate, you know, whatever the narrative is. And also the fact that my idea was to make a documentary which can be understood by everyone, you know, across all faiths and religions. Yeah. It's not only about,
it's not just about Punjabi.
It's not about people who are only Punjabi and Dinanu Dar.
But it's based on three central characters, isn't it? And they're kind of storied, really.
Yes.
So when you were, how did you get them to open up? Because they must, you know, it's 30 years, they must be very mistrustful. There must have been so many
very
people
painful.
Who come and go.
Yeah, true, very true. You rightly said that, actually. So what happens is, Dilli Chajad, the Loki Jandan, you know, reporters, journalists, they go and ask, oh, what happened? And then they just forget about them and then just, you know, they move on with their lives. So when I was there, you know, I had to really bridge this gap and I had to actually answer for a lot of media because I told them, the first thing is I told them who I was, why I'm making the film, mera background ki hai gaya, and you know, everything, I had to bare my soul.
Did you
know,
stay with them?
Stay with them, long time.
Literally,
I was staying in
Fiji, you went native.
Yeah, I was there. I was living right there. So, उत्ते मेरे वास्ते एक issue ऐवी से गा कि you know who's going to give me car, है ना?
It's and quite frightening.
Yeah, it was because in a way because you know there were people who are into drug abuse. So the drug peddlers called me. They said, why are you making this film? The Sikhs, you know, they said कि तुझे क्यों बना रहे हो? तेरे की फायदा होना है. I was like फायदा. I mean.
So they were putting doubts in your mind as well.
Oh yes, you know, I was really. It was very sad and discouraging at a time. You know, see now everyone can watch the film, you can watch it, but the struggle behind is like so sad. You know, they said, what is it that you're going to gain by making this film? I was like, there's no such gain that I'm looking at, you know. I want to make this history available to the people because I think the truth has to be out. And it is sad that Delhi che inne documentary filmmakers ne, but no one really, you know.
Dina, kyunki tusi kya the truth has to be out.
Yeah.
Ah, do ka din hoya jehda Sajjan Kumar tha. Newspaper news acha aaya na bhi one yani ki sting operation
Jagdish Taitla.
So to see ede bare how did you feel? Do you think that koi kidna hai and do you think that this gives us some hope or do you think the justice has gone now that we just have to tell the story now?
See, I had interviewed Jagdish Taitla.
You did?
Yes.
I think it took you about 12 months to get him.
Yes, yes, right.
Yeah.
So his place is there in the film.
So how did you feel? I mean, when you were facing somebody
that who's actually
who is a prime suspect.
Yes, right.
What was your
feelings?
See, you know, in that way, it was very difficult because I didn't know onem no kis din time dena hai gaya or jis din onan ne time ditta minu. My cameraman was not there.
Oh, dear.
So I said, then forget it. I'm just going to go because I don't know how to find another cameraman in Delhi because I'm not from Delhi. So I just went in and I took the camera and he was very surprised. But he had done a lot of research on me. He knew everything about me, where I'm from and all. It was very strange. It was very frightening to me.
This is that in itself revealed. That's almost like an admission of guilt. The fact that he has to prepare so much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To speak
very
to
fearful, very
fearful.
Paranoid.
Yeah.
Paranoia.
Who are you? Where are you? Mm-hmm. Why are you coming to me, etc.
Find out about ins and outs.
So
yeah.
Did you ask him the question?
Of course, I asked him all the questions that were required for.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
he was just defensive about it. See, what happens is we have to understand, you know, even if he is punished, even if Sajjan Kumar is punished, yeah, they are not the only two culprits. Let's remember so
that could be the easy option.
That is the easiest option. We have to remember where is the bigger picture, who are being hidden behind only these two people. These two people are the culprits, but they are not the only two culprits. Yeah. You understand? And jede loki jede us vele sadkan de bahar aaye hai na jinna ne lutte makan sardaran de jinna ne marya, there are only 186 cases in the Supreme Court today. Where are the rest? They've all dissolved. Where are those people? They are still living in Delhi. You understand? So we have to find a way.
Jagdish Singh, we were talking earlier, it's almost as if the Indian state itself is in the dock here.
Yes.
How can 30,000 people, if we take the wider, and in Delhi the estimates vary, some people say 10,000, some people say 3,000. I don't know what the widows said, but I'm sure. How can a state completely absolve itself of any responsibility for this genocide?
In 1984, the Indian state demonstrably, self-evidently went to war with helicopter gunships in June 84. That's phase one of 84. Phase two of 84, they're interlinked. Mm. Phase two was on the national capital of India. Yeah. In full glare of the media, they went on a killing spree of 4 to 5 days of Sikh civilians.
Yeah.
The state allowed this to happen.
So this was part of an ongoing state conspiracy. We'll pick up. We still want to focus on
the state committed this resources and led this.
So we've got a short clip of the documentary itself, and I see all the Karnia. And when the technical team's got that ready, we'll go to that. But
so Tina, what sort of a support and encouragement did you get from your parents?
My parents are very, very supportive about it, you know, and also
so especially you're a lady as well.
Yes, right.
Okay, we've got the.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a documentary clip, yeah.
Right.
That tusi aap dekh sakde ha kis tarah kinni quality de naal aur kinni ek kisi sachai bayan hundi ha. Jidda apa gal kiti si, there were some characters, some widows there. So aao dekho ji clip ta mud ke judange ji.
Announced the death of the Prime Minister, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. She was critically injured this morning at a residence when she was
shot. ਨੇ ਅੰਨੀਆਂ ਡੈਡ ਬੋਡੀਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਕੀਤਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਨੇ ਅੰਨੇ ਜੋ 5000 ਬੰਦੇ ਮਾਰੇ ਤੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਡੈਡ ਬੋਡੀਆਂ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਕੀਤੀਆਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਤੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਨਾ ਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਵੇਖਿਆ ਤੇ ਨਾ ਸਾੜਿਆ ਹੱਥਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਨਾ ਪਰਵਾਹਿਤ ਕੀਤੀ
ਜਿਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਛੁੱਟੀ ਗਿਆ ਨਾ ਕਿਤੇ ਛੁੱਟੀ ਗਿਆ ਉਸ ਦਿਨ ਉਹਨੇ ਕੱਢੀਆਂ ਨਾ ਲਾਸ਼ਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਵਿੱਚੋਂ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਜਿੰਦੇ ਨਿਕਲੇ
ਕਿਸੇ ਨਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੇ ਤਾਂ ਕੀਤਾ ਨਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੀ ਸਾਜਿਸ਼ ਨਾਲ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੇ ਮਤਲਬ ਆਰਡਰ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਜਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਹੋਇਆ ਨਾ ਉਸ ਵੇਲੇ ਪੁਲਿਸ ਕਿਤੇ ਗਈ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ 3 ਦਿਨ ਤੱਕ ਆਰਮੀ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਗਈ ਸਾਰੇ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਗਏ
ਫੇਸਬੁੱਕ 'ਤੇ
ਹਾਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੈਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਵਟਸਐਪ
ਪਾਪਾ ਜਦੋਂ ਅੱਜ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਹਾਂ ਤੇ ਯਹਾਂ ਆ ਕੇ ਬਰਬਾਦ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਪੂਰੀ ਲਾਈਫ ਖਤਮ
ਹੋਇਆ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਾਇਆ ਗਿਆ ਕੀਤਾ ਹੈ ਕਾਂਗਰਸ ਨੇ ਜਾਣ ਕੇ
ਜਿਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਤਨ ਤੇ ਮਨ ਤੇ ਪੀੜਾ ਹੰਡਾਈ ਸੀ 84 ਦੀ ਉਹ ਮਹਿਸੂਸ ਕਰ ਗਏ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕੋਈ ਗਲਤੀ ਕੀਤੀ ਉਹ ਸੋਚਣ ਦੇ ਐਡੀ ਛੇਤੀ ਭੁੱਲ ਗਏ
ਇਹ ਸਾਰੀ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਗੀ ਜੋ ਤੋਂ ਸੰਸਾਰ ਰਹੇਗਾ ਇਹ ਭੁੱਲਣ ਵਾਲੀ ਯਾਦਦਾਸ਼ਤ ਨਹੀਂ
Seconds. ਇਹ ਸੀ ਛੋਟੀ ਜਿਹੀ ਟ੍ਰੇਲਰ ਉਸ ਜੋ ਡਾਕੂਮੈਂਟਰੀ ਟੀਨਾ ਕੌਰ ਨੇ 1984 ਨਵੰਬਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜੋ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮਸ ਹੋਏ ਸੋ ਟੀਨਾ ਆਪਾਂ ਗੱਲ ਕਰਦੇ ਸੀ ਵੀ ਇਹਦੇ ਸੈਂਟਰਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਸਟੋਰੀ ਰਿਵੋਲਵਸ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ ਥ੍ਰੀ ਕੈਰੈਕਟਰਸ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਵਿਡੋਜ਼ ਆ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਨੋ ਵਨ ਆਫ ਦ ਟ੍ਰੈਜਡੀਜ਼ ਇਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਆ ਮੈਂਟਲ ਇਲਨੈਸ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਆ ਡਰੱਗ ਅਡਿਕਸ਼ਨ 'ਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਗੱਲ ਕੀਤੀ ਸੀਗੀ ਔਰ some of them just lost kind of hope really. I mean, what is the kind of, what was the atmosphere there?
See, the atmosphere is obviously, I mean, you know, in a way they've moved on, you know, in their lives and they don't want to remember this particular event because also it's very traumatic for them and they don't know how to deal with it any longer.
But did they have they had counseling or have they just been supporting each other?
That's what I'm coming to. Mm. What happens is whenever such kind of an event happens which is so gruesome, most of the time it is the basic human survival that is taken care of, like food, you know, shelter, clothes and stuff like that. ਅਤੇ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਲੋਕ ਨੇ ਨਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਇਹੋ ਜਿਹੀ ਕਾਊਂਸਲਿੰਗ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਿਲੀ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦੇ ਵਾਜ਼ ਨੋ ਵਨ ਹੂ ਟੂ ਟੈਲ ਦੈਮ ਦੈਟ ਹਾਊ ਟੂ ਕਮ ਆਊਟ ਆਫ ਇਟ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਲੀ ਸੋ ਦੈਟਸ ਵਾਟ ਆਈ ਰਿਅਲਾਈਜ਼ਡ
ਵੈਨ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਫਲੈਸ਼ਬੈਕਸ ਐਂਡ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਦੈਟ ਪੇਨ ਕਮ ਬੈਕ ਟੂ ਯੂ
ਯਾ
ਇਟਸ ਡਿਫਿਕਲਟ
ਸੋ ਵਾਟ ਹੈਪਨਡ ਵੈਨ ਆਈ ਵਾਜ਼ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਦੈਮ ਐਂਡ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਟ੍ਰਾਈਂਗ ਟੂ ਸਪੈਂਡ ਟਾਈਮ ਐਂਡ ਮੇਰੀ ਕਾਫੀ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਮੇਰੇ ਫਰੈਂਡਸ ਬਣ ਗਏ ਹੈ ਨਾ ਦੈਨ ਆਈ ਰਿਅਲਾਈਜ਼ ਵੈਨ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਟਾਕਿੰਗ ਟੂ ਮੀ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਲਾਈਕ ਇਨ ਅ ਵੇ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਆਲਸੋ ਗੈਟਿੰਗ ਰਿਲੀਵਡ You know, so this was very strange at that time. I didn't even know what is counseling and stuff when I started.
Just like listening and speaking.
Yes.
Yeah.
So for me, I didn't know how to deal with it. But then I realized that I was becoming very, very emotionally heavy. But they really felt lighter and better after That's talking good, to me about it.
Jagdish Singh ji, jadon apan har saal 1984 nu manaunde haan, when we commemorate that or remember that. Diddi de vich vi us dinan ch jehde politician aunde aa and they go to the colony but oh atfer ke chal jande aa and in some senses they exploit it for their own purposes. I mean, this is one of the tragedies. You know, we talk about the Delhi committee. I mean, even recently Manjeet Singh ji has been making so many powerful ashi jagdish title no ek kar dunga
sade jathebandi more
so you do wonder whether their real motives are something. I mean, how do the people there feel about that, the politicians?
They all know that, you know, they are being used as vote bank politics, you know, because 30 years have passed, you know, 3 decades have passed, and they know that, you know, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਮ 'ਤੇ ਕੋਈ ਜਸਟਿਸ ਤਾਂ ਹੋਇਆ ਨਹੀਂ ਹਾਲੇ ਤੱਕ ਜਦ ਵੀ ਇਲੈਕਸ਼ਨਸ ਆਉਂਦੇ ਨੇ ਐਵਰੀ ਵਨ ਕਮਸ ਟੂ ਦੈਮ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਵਾਜ਼ ਦੇਅਰ ਐਟ ਦ ਟਾਈਮ ਆਫ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਇਲੈਕਸ਼ਨਸ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਇਟ ਵਾਜ਼ ਸੋ ਸੈਡ ਦੈਟ ਆਈ ਸੋ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਇਲੈਕਸ਼ਨਸ 'ਤੇ ਕੋਈ ਸ਼ਰਾਬਾਂ ਵੰਡ ਕੇ ਵੀ ਵੋਟ ਲੈ ਸਕਦਾ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਵਾਟ ਆਈ ਸੋ
ਐਂਡ
I lost all faith, believe me. I said, Baba ji, kite bhi ho sakde ne, jithon hai aaye ne, othe te nahi hege.
So, it's a proof hai, Jagdish Singh ji, jehde oh sharaba vandde si us din, ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਫਿਰ ਵੋਟ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਪਿਆ ਰਿਹਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਸੋਲ ਸਿਧਾਂਤ ਦੀ ਤਾਂ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਹੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਉਹ
ਤਾਂ ਅਸੀਂ
ਇਨਸਾਨੀਅਤ ਦਾ ਕੋਈ ਨਹੀਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਦਰ ਤੇ
ਉਹਨੇ ਹੈ
ਮੰਚ ਤਾਂ ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਦੁੱਖ ਨਾਲ ਭਰ ਲਿਆ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਸਾਡੀ ਸੋ ਕਾਲਡ ਸਿੱਖ ਲੀਡਰਸ਼ਿਪ ਆ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਅੰਮ੍ਰਿਤਸਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹ ਇੰਨੀ ਰੋਟਨ ਹੋ ਚੁੱਕੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਹਨਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਆਸਾਂ ਹੀ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਟੁੱਟ ਚੁੱਕੀਆਂ
ਪਰ ਜੇ ਨਾ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਖਬਰਾਂ ਮਿਲਦੀਆਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਉਹ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ ਨੂੰ ਮੁਆਵਜ਼ਾ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਪੈਨਸ਼ਨਸ
ਬੜਾ ਕੁਝ
ਬੜਾ ਦਾਵਾ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਆ ਵੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਪਾਰਟੀ ਤੋਂ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਕੀ ਡੂ ਦੇ ਗੈਟ ਵਾਟ ਕਾਈਂਡ ਆਫ ਸਪੋਰਟ ਵਾਟ ਕਾਈਂਡ ਆਫ ਏਡ ਡੂ ਦੇ ਗੈਟ ਮਟੀਰੀਅਲ ਸਪੋਰਟ
ਸੀ ਵਾਟ ਹੈਪਨਸ ਨਾ ਇਹ ਸਮਝਣ ਵਾਲੀ ਗੱਲ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਇੰਨੇ ਹੁਣ 30 ਸਾਲਾਂ 'ਚ ਜਦ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਬੜਾ ਡਿਫੀਕਲਟ ਡੈਲੀਕੇਟ ਟਾਈਮ ਸੀਗਾ ਨਾ ਉਸ ਵੇਲੇ ਤਾਂ ਸਪੋਰਟ ਮਿਲੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਜਦ ਬੱਚੇ ਛੋਟੇ ਸੀਗੇ ਵੈਨ ਦੇ ਰੀਅਲੀ ਵਾਂਟਡ ਮਨੀ ਦੇ ਹੈਡ ਟੂ ਵਰਕ
ਦ ਡੈਮੇਜ ਹੈਸ ਬੀਨ ਡਨ ਨਾਓ
ਨਾਓ ਵਾਟ ਹੈਪਨਸ ਹੁਣ ਵੋਟ ਬੈਂਕ ਦੇ ਚੱਕਰ 'ਚ ਨਾ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਕਦੀ ਇਹ ਮਤਲਬ ਬੜੀ ਮੁਸ਼ਕਿਲਾਂ ਨਾਲ 5 ਸਾਲ ਬਾਅਦ ਕੋਈ ਥੋੜ੍ਹੇ ਦੇ ਦਿੰਦਾ ਫਿਰ ਚੁੱਪ ਕਰਾਉਣ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਪੈਸੇ ਲੈਣ ਫਿਰ ਦੇ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਮਿਲ ਗਿਆ ਨਾਓ ਦ ਥਿੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਵਾਟ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਵੈਰੀ ਸੈਕਲੂਡਿਡ ਫਰੋਮ ਦ ਮੇਨ ਸਟ੍ਰੀਮ ਸੋਸਾਇਟੀ ਆਫ ਡੈਲੀ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਦੇ ਲੋਕ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਲੋਕਡਾਊਨ ਪਾਉਣ ਕਰਦੇ ਨੇ ਕਿ ਬਈ ਇਹ ਤੇ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਲਾਈਕ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਪੂਅਰ ਪੀਪਲ ਉਹ ਦੇ ਕੀਪ ਮੇਕਿੰਗ ਨੋਇਜ਼ਸ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਇਟਸ ਲਾਈਕ ਦੈਟ ਓ ਵੀ ਰੀਅਲੀ ਫੀਲ ਸੈਡ ਫॉर ਯੂ ਬਟ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਨਾਟ ਗੋਇੰ ਟੂ ਲਾਈਕ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਵੀ ਜਸਟ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਫੋਰਗੇਟ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਯੂ
ਇਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਅ ਕਾਸਟ ਪੋਲਿਟਿਕਸ ਪਲੇਇੰਗ ਦੈਟ ਐਸ ਵੈਲ
ਆਫ ਕੋਰਸ 100% ਯੂ ਨੋ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਸੋ ਸੈਡ ਵਾਈ ਆਰ ਵੀ ਵਾਟ ਹੈਵ ਹੈਪਨਡ ਟੂ ਅਸ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਵਾਈ ਆਰ ਵੀ ਲੁਕਿੰਗ ਐਟ ਪੀਪਲ ਐਸ ਸਿਕਲੀਗਰ ਸਿੱਖਸ ਰਾਮਗੜਿਆ ਸਿੱਖਸ ਅਰੋੜਾ ਸਿੱਖਸ ਵਾਟ ਇਜ਼ ਰੋਂਗ ਕਿਹਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿਹੜੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਦੇਖੋ ਹਨਾ ਤੇ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਵੈਰੀ ਸੈਡ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਹੈਪਨਿੰਗ ਆਈ ਮੀਨ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੂਸਰੇ ਰਿਲੀਜਨ ਤੇ ਵੀ ਕਿਉਂ ਗੱਲ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੋ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਸੋ ਡਿਵਾਈਡਡ ਪੀਪਲ ਇਨ ਇਨ ਕਾਸਟ
ਦਿਸ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਆਪਾਂ
ਚਲੋ ਜੀ ਬਟ ਦ ਡਾਕੂਮੈਂਟਰੀ ਹਾਊ ਹੈਵ ਦ ਸਿੱਖ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਰਿਸੀਵਡ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਨਾਨ ਸਿੱਖਸ ਹਾਊ ਦੇ ਬਟ ਦ ਡਾਕੂਮੈਂਟਰੀ ਹਾਊ ਦੇ ਰਿਸੀਵਡ ਇਟ ਕਿਦਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ
non-Sikhs, I mean, I wouldn't look in the world. No. I don't really look at people as Sikhs and non-Sikhs, to be honest. But if you talk about Indians in general, like...
Sure,
I'm just coming to that. Jidda Kolkata or the Thiruvananthapuram, Delhi, Bombay dikhai gai. So everyone was really appreciative and everyone was very emotional. And they all understand and appreciate that, you know, Sikhs are serving into the army. We've brought Green Revolution and, you know, they are such nice people. Gurdwara langar waste khade khade log ke mainu is tarah appreciate karke jande ne when I talk to them this what has happened. So they asked me, you know, Gurdwara is such a nice place. I met a white lady today and she was talking about it. Everyone has been equally good and responsive about it, hai na? But there are a few people who know
but that's a very important point, because there's a narrative here that was presented that somehow these were mobs of Hindus who were killing these Sikhs. But what we're saying is actually, sadi da rai kise Indian de naal kise nagrik de naal nahi hai. It's the system that was really and the party.
Yes. See, please understand, jo aadmi ik aadmi nu maran aanda hai, oda koi taram nahi hunda, oda koi religion nahi hunda. Theek hai, that's point number one. Point number two, these people who came to kill, they were the ones who were paid. You know, they were paid ek 100 rupaye naal ek daru di bottle, theek hai, te unna da koi taram nahi siga. I think it's wrong to judge them. Another thing that happened was there were a lot of Hindus who came in support of Sikhs and they really really protected. Binu bahut sari kahaniyan mildiyan ne aur bahut sare matlab dusre walks of life, dusre faiths the log bhi Delhi
the
they came and tell me ki na
you know, it's a point about Jagdish Singh, because you see you've been working on the human rights. ਆਪਾਂ ਜੇ ਇੱਕ ਦੋ ਪੋਲੀਟੀਸ਼ੀਅਨਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਵੀ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਸਿੱਟਦੇ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਗਲਤ ਆ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਜੇ ਜਗਦੀਸ਼ ਟਾਈਟਲ ਵਰਗੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਕੀਤਾ, ਜੇ ਰਾਜੀਵ ਗਾਂਧੀ ਨੇ ਕੀਤਾ, ਪਿੱਛੇ ਕੋਈ ਮਸ਼ੀਨਰੀ ਹੋ ਗਈ ਤਦੀ ਕੀਤਾ, ਇਹਨਾਂ ਮੋਬਲਾਈਜੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਦ ਮੋਬਸ. ਪਰ ਦੂਜੇ ਪਾਸੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਕਹਿ ਸਕਦਾ ਵੀ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਮੋਬ ਸੀ ਜਿਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕੋਲਡ ਬਲੱਡਡ ਕਿਲਿੰਗਸ ਕੀਤੀਆਂ ਸੀਗੀਆਂ, ਸ਼ਾਇਦ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਕੋਈ ਨਸ਼ਾ ਜਾਂ ਕੋਈ ਪੈਸਾ ਦਾ ਲਾਲਚ ਸੀ. ਸੋ ਹੂ ਇਜ਼ ਰਿਸਪੋਂਸੀਬਲ?
ਇਹ ਦੇਖੋ, ਉਹ ਸੰਗਤ ਸਿੰਘ ਜਿਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਬੁੱਕ ਲਿਖੀ ਸੀ Sikhs, history of the Sikhs.
Yeah.
ਉਹ ਬੜੇ ਸੀਨੀਅਰ ਸੀਗੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਇੰਡੀਅਨ ਸਿਵਲ ਸਰਵਿਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ. ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਇਹ ਗੱਲ ਪੇਸ਼ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਆਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਫੇਸ ਟੂ ਆਫ 1984 ਜਿਹੜਾ ਹੋਣਾ ਸੀ, ਉਹ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਰੈਡੀ ਸੀਗਾ ਪੋਸਟ ਜੂਨ 84. ਉਹ ਹਜੇ ਮੌਕਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਸੀ, ਮੌਕਾ ਆਏਗਾ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਵਿਲ ਸੈਟ ਇਟ ਇਨ ਮੋਸ਼ਨ. ਆਹ ਕਿੱਥੋਂ ਇੱਕ ਇਨ 24 hours ਵੋਟਰਸ ਲਿਸਟ ਇੱਕਦਮ ਕਿੱਥੋਂ ਆ ਗਈਆਂ? ਕੈਰੋਸੀਨ ਇੱਡੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਪੱਤਰ 'ਤੇ ਕਿੱਥੋਂ ਆ ਗਿਆ? ਹਥਿਆਰ ਇੱਡੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਪੱਤਰ 'ਤੇ ਕਿੱਥੋਂ ਆ ਗਿਆ?
ਕਮਿਸ਼ਨ ਨਾਨਾਵਤੀ ਕਮਿਸ਼ਨ, ਕਮਿਸ਼ਨ ਆਫਟਰ ਕਮਿਸ਼ਨ ਆਫਟਰ ਕਮਿਸ਼ਨ, ਦੇ ਆਰ ਰਿਪੀਟਿੰਗ ਦ ਸੇਮ ਐਵਿਡੈਂਸ, ਬਟ ਦ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਇਜ਼ ਅਨੇਬਲ ਟੂ ਮੂਵ ਟੂ ਗਿਵ ਜਸਟਿਸ. ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਕੀ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ.
ਦ
ਸਟੇਟ ਵਾਸ ਰੈਡੀ ਟੂ ਕਿਲ ਐਂਡ ਮਰਡਰ ਯੂ. ਇਟ ਹੈਡ ਪਲਾਨ ਟੂ ਡੂ ਦੈਟ ਐਂਡ ਇਟ ਕੈਰੀਡ ਆਊਟ ਇਟਸ ਪਲਾਨ. ਨਾਓ ਉਹੀ ਸਟੇਟ ਦੇ ਹੇਠਾਂ you are asking for justice. Justice akhna vi chahida, mangna vi chahida. But the tragedy is, we are going to the tyrannical state.
But is it too late for justice now?
Dina,
is
it too late now?
No, not at all. I really feel there's other ways of achieving justice which we are not looking at and we are not really putting our energies and efforts into it. The thing is, there are institutes of Holocaust studies in Europe, in Netherlands, in Belgium, in UK, even in Canada. So if we go there and give our host historical writings, show the film and say that, would you like to consider this? I'm sure there'll
be people. Let me tell you about this, because I've done a study in the Simon Wiesenthal Foundation, Siggy. They were called the Nazi hunters. And what they did was that they hunted down the Nazis, whether it was Adolf Eichmann in Argentina or if it was Rudolf Hess. They got them and they brought them to the Israeli, to Israel, and they tried them and they gave the justice. Where do we take Sajjan Kumar, Jagdish Taitler, when the system itself is protecting them?
See, the idea is that, you know, we are talking about criminal justice.
Is the UN? Can we go to the UN? Where do we go?
Yeah, we can go to United Nations. We can go to Amnesty. We can always ask them
The Hague? Can we go to the International Human Rights?
Of course, we can go there. And of course, you know, I'm really... the reason why I brought the film first to UK was because I have a belief that there are many human rights organizations which are here, and I'm sure someone can come forward and take the film there, show the film there, and you know, take, you know, try and achieve justice in a way that it is declaration of genocide by human rights organizations, by recognition of this particular massacre in the history.
Arjun Jaitley, who is the Home Minister, he's on record as has been said that it was a genocide. Mm. So it's on record, but still yes. nothing happens.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
See, it's also because, you know, the history is being told by the people who are rich and powerful and they are in power, you know. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to share the history, the truth through the perspective of minorities who suffered.
Yeah.
So it might take time, but I'm very sure that, you know, something can be done. Like, you know, I saw these on these websites, you know, Rohingya victims naal jada hoya. It has been already being studied as a genocide. You know, it's effortless. Mm. So why can't we really take it forward and try and see, you know, what are the other ways of achieving justice? You know, I know criminal justice, I'm not really very hopeful about it. Even if Jagdish Tyagi and Sajjan Kumar is punished, I don't think I'll be really happy. Because the thing is, in the history books, it should be there. There's no genocide law in the Constitution of India. Jira Sardinal injustice hoya, oh Godhra rights chevi hoya, oh Mumbai chevi hoya. There are so many people who are there. Mm. So, you know, because India is really rich and there are so many people.
You know, the narrative for that was that Dange, even today, when you say the politician speaking, okay, Delhi Dange se gaye, that there were riots. So even on there, they're not prepared to use the word genocide.
No. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. So there is a really important struggle there, isn't it, in terms of how we label this.
Yeah, even UK there is a selection of UK politicians, parliamentarians, some who are prepared to use the word genocide in respect of 84, and some who are specifically refusing to use the word genocide in respect
of 84. We've got last 3 minutes.
So what hope do you have for the future, for the widow colony? Colony, yeah.
Yeah. See, the thing is, it's not only about the widow's colony, it's about how each one of us can try and achieve justice in our lives and wherever we are and what do we stand for. And I really think if you really are emotional about it, if you want to do something about it, commemorate, you know, June or commemorate the dates 31st October, 3rd of November. Do it in different ways, you know. One way for me is like, because I'm very passionate about environment, so I would consider, distributing free saplings to people. And when people say thank you to you, then you tell them, you know, this is what happened and we are trying to make this world better by you know, commemorating the injustice that happened. So, vaddi lakeer de, choti lakeer de agge, vaddi lakeer kicho te. Haan, they are very sweet people and they are very, very encouraging as well, because it was, you know, they live in Ajmer, Rajasthan, and I'm in Bombay and I'm away like from them.
But Jigra bhi ona da
Jigra making a documentary is a big thing.
It's a risky business. It's a risky business. Even now you're taking a risk.
You're traveling and you know.
So, but then the thing is that, you know, that I think that life, you have to take up challenges, you know, you just can't.
They have faith in you.
Yeah, and
well.
Also the fact that, you know, which I think, tere tere unhaan nu samajh aaya ki, you know, what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to.
Changa kar rahe hain, kaam le.
Then other things, I'm also doing other work and documentaries, jede film festival jaandiyan ne, they feel good about it, that it's written about and stuff.
Jagdish Singh Ji, sometimes with these kind of. The documentary, they're like kind of art nouveau, it's kind of for the liberal intelligentsia that go and watch these things. But this is different because what Tina's doing is she's going to the Sikh, she's going to societies, universities and gurdwaras as well.
Yeah.
How important is it for the grassroots and the young people to get involved in these issues?
The whole 1984 phenomena, it's happened. Who is actually taking control of it? We don't want an elitist Sikh leadership to mangle it all up. They already have.
Yeah.
We need the ordinary grassroots Punjabi to drive it and run with it. We need the Punjabi voice to reach out to the global world.
Yeah.
The global media is not discussing 1984.
No.
The global world politicians are not discussing 1984. That is a gaping hole in the 1984 jigsaw. Well,
Tina, are you just a drop in the ocean or are you part of maybe a new generation of young Sikhs in India who are becoming politically aware, active, and actually we see in the West, in Canada, and in UK and Australia, we see now young Sikhs coming forward with the Jaggi campaign. Are you seeing something? Have you got hope that the new generation will follow the kind of lead that you're maybe offering? And
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, of course. You know, I'm really hoping that there'll be so many more people who can support this campaign, who can take this campaign forward. You know, I'm trying my best to do that, but I definitely need much more people to get part of
it. So you've taken the lead. You need some other people behind you.
Yes, support it, because for now there is an organization called Nishan that is working with the universities in the Sikh societies there, and that's how we are holding the screenings.
So how can people get information about the viewings? Mm-hmm. Is there a website? Have you got?
So there's a Facebook page, you know, of Nishan, where you can go and find the schedule, and also the Facebook page of the film is also there. When the Sun Didn't Rise, the schedule is there as well. So if you just Google it, I'm sure you'll be able to find it.
And of course, we are live on Facebook at the moment on Akaal Channel Facebook. We've got 1.7 million followers on the Facebook, so potentially there's a lot of people out there. And I'm sure, have you got a Twitter hashtag for this?
Do
you know what it is?
Yeah, I mean, my Twitter handle is @TinaKaur, TEENAAKAUR. So you can tweet to me and share your support, come for the screening. They're all free screenings. And of course, you can pay as per you like if you wish to.
If you want
to
donate any,
of course, because the idea is that, you know, to keep it going. And definitely, you know, I haven't received any grant from anywhere. So
future projects, because this was your first venture into documentary?
No, not really.
I know you did the one on Holamalla.
No, there are other three more documentary films which are on wildlife conservation. I work on environment a lot.
Okay. So, but this was more to do with politics.
This is more to do with what my heart says,
So what's next then? What's next?
So then? I think I'm going to stand for justice and make more documentary films. Then of course I'm pitching a feature film script which is ready. So because I feel
On the 84.
There is a script on 84. If anyone of you is there interested, please get in touch. I would be very happy to pitch the script
to
you.
That's a good point, Jagdish. I've got to be honest, a lot of the films that have been made of the period have been very poor quality, often low budget, Why hasn't Hollywood picked up these really, really tragic stories? They are powerful storylines here.
Yeah. Very,
is it because of the pressure of the Indian government?
It's a combination.
Or even Bollywood hasn't really picked it up either.
No. See, the thing is that,
This is the gaping hole. For the last 30 years, the global Sikh community has failed itself to engage the global media. We bang on within our internal media. We've remained restricted within
the mainstream.
We haven't hit the mainstream. And few of us.
And that's where we need to go.
Where we had to go in June 84. We didn't.
No.
So the media has misrepresented, picked us up, dropped us. And because we haven't hit the major New York Times, the BBC, the Al Jazeeras, because of that, governments think, ignore the Sikhs. They have their little Sunday protests.
We are running out of time, but have you any possibility of Channel 4 or some of the big broadcasters in India showing this? Have you got any possibility there?
For now, I don't know. There's no such thing that is in pipeline, but I'm sure I would love to. BBC had watched the cut of the film. They said that it's very emotional. It's too emotional for the British audience.
Really?
So, So I was like, okay, I mean, I can't do much about it. You know, it is an emotional film.
That's right. So,
but it's well balanced. I just want to say that it's well
just
balanced.
Just a final message to the viewers, maybe.
Yes. So we're going to start our Midlands trip on 23rd of February, and we're going to be there in the Midlands, but also in London, in Imperial College and KCL and Queen's and Mary. We're going to hold the screenings on the weekdays, and on the weekends it's the Gurdwaras. So please come, find the schedule online, and wherever you can come, please spread the word and come and support the film.
Okay.
I'll be very happy if
Tina,
you do so.
It was an honor to have you today.
Yeah. Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity.
I'm very proud to have Aditi, and she's, you know, she's trailblazing, and she's showing us how to not just talk, but actually act on it. Fight for justice. So this is the documentary, When the Sun Didn't Rise, Sikh Massacre in October, November 1984. As Tina herself has said, that this is it's travelling around the country, various universities, and also Gurdwaras the weekend. So if you go onto the website, even just Google the documentary, you'll get the information on Facebook as well. So, ek baar fir
swagat thoda. Thank you to Jagdish as well.
And good luck with the feature. And
definitely.
Hopefully we'll have you back maybe later on. Why could you kakal sa?
Why could you kakal
Bole sone hal sa.
अकाल चैनल नू सब्सक्राइब करो नवी वीडियोस दी नोटिफिकेशन दे ले बेल आइकन नू क्लिक करना ना भूलना